Hello my friends, Rune here again. So, first of all, big thanks for all the get well in my last video after the heart attack I had. So, thank you much for the kind words. And now, shout out to YouTube channels Ear Gunner Reviews and Ear Guns Anonymous. Make sure to check them out. So, I have bought another HDP50. I thought I want to have another one. Not sure I tinker with it, but I think I will keep it as it is. Maybe try it without the restrictor. And that's about it. So, looks like so. I have the 11 joule version. So, if you have seen my other videos, I put on a long barrel and barrel shroud from Home Defense 24. On this one, I thought I would just use it as it is, at least for now. But, yeah. I can't find my rubber balls, but I have some balls a friend from Cyprus sent me. These are 14.6 grain, and I've also made some balls with this ball marker type thing that my friend Craig sent me. So I made them with hot glue. Nice and round. These weigh on average about 15.4 to 15.8 grains. So just around 1 gram. Same weight as the rubber balls, almost. But these will fly way too fast for my extra dark runner to read. So I thought let's try steel balls. I have some 12.5mm steel balls, also from my friend in Cyprus. So these are 8 gram. I have some 12.7mm also, that I guess it will shoot, but you risk damaging the detent, because it's just a rubber gasket. That happened on my other pistol. So I don't want to shoot like oversized ammo from it. But one thing I thought we could try is speed loader from Florian Sølner at homedefense24.com. Looks like so. It has a small rail underneath here. Hole on top. It doesn't have any kind of screws or anything, so I guess the way you use it is just pour in the balls there and slide the cover on. It sits relatively snug there. Looks like so. So we can try this one. So, but first let's charge it up with some CO2. This is the first handling. Down here you can see the restrictor. Not sure if it is visible on camera. So later maybe we can take that out and try it without without restrictor. See how that works. So, silicone spray from Vicon. Good dose down there. As always, Umarex CO2 canister. Some silicone oil on that push button thing also. So let's see what I tried today. I thought we could try the steel balls and maybe aluminium balls and see what sort of energy we can get. So let's load up steel balls. Just drop them down into the hole on top there. I forgot to count. Only 5. Five balls. I think the sixth ball would prevent it from sliding on. So okay, 5 balls it is. Looks like so, and then just slide it onto the, to the rail. Like so. Then you can store it in your drawer or something, wherever you keep your pistol. And when you're ready to shoot, tilt the barrel upwards, pull the magazine follower forward or up. Let's see if I can do it on camera. And that way the balls roll down into the magazine. It should be able to fit one more, but in the magazine here, but the speed loader only holds 5. So yeah, let's step into my bedroom, aka my shooting range, and see what sort of power it gives. So, let's see how it works. I hope it won't leak and that there won't be any problem. If it is, then I will return it. But let's see how it goes. Hit that push button to puncture. Gas it up. Room temperature, about 20 degrees Celsius. Steel balls, 8 gram. Not shooting at anything specific, just into my trap there. So let us see. .223. 8 gram ball. So that is relatively decent for a 11-year-old version, I think. Holter, 242. Remember, this is a stock pistol. I have just loaded it up for the first time I used it. I have not tinkered with it or done anything. Same velocity again, 242. Dropping a little bit, 235. I don't want to shoot the balls on top of each other, so I fish them out after each shot. It should be one more inside. 224. So, and now let's try aluminium balls, 2.8 gram. I think I'll just remove this and load the balls straight into the pistol. Six balls, and then you loosen up that magazine folder. 2.8 gram aluminium balls. Why won't it shoot? Hmm. 371. It doesn't like the aluminium balls for some reason. Not sure why. I think there should be one ball into the bridge. No, nothing. So let's try the steel balls again. Five shots. Eight gram. 225. Steel balls works great, so I don't know why it don't like the aluminium balls. Very strange. Dropping fast, 203. So this thing is using a lot of CO2. It should be one more. Yes. 180. Loaded up with just four balls. These hot glue balls, 5 grains on average. Let's see if my chrony will read it now, since the pistol is starting to get low on CO2. Over 400 feet per second and very high sound. Let me just and no more CO2 gas. So there you have it, first handling of my new Umarex HDP50. Very cool pistol indeed. Nice big puncture, and I mean big puncture of the CO2 canister there. I have no idea what size that restrictor has. It is usually 0.2 millimeters in diameter, the small hole in the restrictor. But since it is blasting off most of the CO2 gas within 15 shots, then I suspect it might be a little bit larger. Of course, in the 11 joule version, there is no valve block. So, yeah, cool pistol. I do not understand why the aluminium bolts won't feed. The hot glue balls are quite small, so I think these aluminium balls are more or less exactly 12.7 millimeter, and that makes it jam for some reason. It could be the gasket, because it is a new pistol and it needs to be shot a bit to wear in. I don't know. I don't understand. But that's how it is. Speed loader works fine. Too bad it only holds 5 balls and not 6, because the pistol itself holds 6. But it doesn't matter. And it looks quite cool with that one on. So yeah. Yes. Just a little test of my new pistol. I will make more videos of it. Try it without the restrictor, and maybe put 88 gram canister on the bottom, or whatever. Just me having some fun testing stuff. So just hope I don't have another heart attack or something. Yes, okay, not much more to say. So I hope you liked the video. See you again another time, and thank you for watching.